this tutorial, I'm going to talk about the pointer. The pointer is the most important operation in C, and if you don't learn about the pointer, then you haven't learned about C programming. A pointer is an address of an object in memory. Because an array is itself a pointer. Also, array is a pointer. Then the uses of arrays and pointers are intimately related. The simple example, if we define A equal 1, B equal 2, and a pointer, an integer of pointer P, then in the memory, it has been allocated a place for A with the value 1, allocated a place for B with the value 2, and allocate a memory for P, but it doesn't know it pointed to what yet. But during the program, if you are writing P equal address A, the sign, the symbol, and it means address in C programming, then P is going to point to address A. What is contained? Then it is pointing to address A, which has a value 1. If we are writing B equal pointed P, then B is going to get the value 1, because it is B is a single simple variable, integer variable, and it's going to get the value 1. And this expression is equivalent to B equal A. Another example is, if you define I equal 3, J equal 5, and pointed P equal address of I, which is the 3, and pointed Q equal by address J, which is 5, and another pointer R. The expression pointed address P is equivalent to pointed of pointed address P, and it is equivalent to P equal address I, and it is the value, it has the value 3. Now, if we multiply 7 multiple to pointed 3 P divided by pointed Q plus 7, it means that 7 multiple to pointed P. Pointed P is the address of E, which is 3. 7 multiple by 3 is 21, divided by pointed Q. Pointed Q is what is in address J, and it is 5. Also, 21 divided by 5 is 4, and the whole result plus 7 is 11. Another example is, you can define R is the usual pointer, and you can initialize R with address J, which is 5, and what is pointing the address, this is expression, which is 5, multiple equal pointed P. It means that this expression equal this expression multiple by pointed P, which is 3 pointed 2, which is 5, multiple to 3 is 15. Now we are going to write this one is our program, put it in our program. And here is this one is not necessary, but here of between slash star you must put in one space, otherwise it slash star make the rest as comment. And it is very important that you do that. And it is seven. And this expression is correct. And I am going to put away. And I am going to print f d. New. The first one is 3, the second one is 11, and the third one is 15. Okay, now we are going to use another example, and we are going to include string.h for usage of string copy, and we have defined variable max string with 100, and its value is 100, and I am going to find a variable, a character, one character, A, and it is in the simple quote. And I have defined a pointer P, a character of pointer, and another character or an string because it is an array. I have defined an array of characters with 100 elements. Max string has a value 100 and it is equivalent to S of 100. I have a pointer and I define P equal address C, means P points in what is in address C. In address C, it is only a simple character A. Now I am going to print F characters. What is P pointing, which is A, and what is the next after this character, and what is the second after character A, and then I am going to copy what is the character after A is B, what is the second character after B is C. Then we are going to get A, B, C in lowercase. Now we are using a string copy. In S, put that string, uppercase A, B, C. It's going to put that string inside that string, because that string has a length of 100. That length is 3, and it has enough space. Now we are going to print S, which is ABC with a string format, and we are using tab, and then I am going to write two single characters with the C format, and it is, what is S pointing? The pointer of S. You know that S is array, and an array is a pointer. What S is pointing? The S is pointing to the first element, which is A, plus 6, then A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And because it begins from 0, we told that it begins from 0, then the sixth element after that, it is G. And the seventh element after that is H. Now, when I am writing S plus 1, it means that you must jump from the first element and write what is the rest of the S, which is BC. Now, if I string copy, if I put a phrase in S, I am using string copy seashells by the sea shore, and this phrase is going to be set in S, which has a lower than 100 elements, and it get place, otherwise you are going to get a warning. And now we are putting P equal S plus 14, and when you count 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and when we write P, print out P, it appears shells by the seashore, the rest after the 14 place, it's going to write the rest, shells by the seashore. Now we run this program. The first one is P, pointed P. Pointed P is character A. P plus 1 is the next character after that, what P point is B. The second character after B, A, is C. Now I have put ABC in S, and I have printed out as string, which is ABC, and I am writing the sixth element after A. The first, what is S pointing, is A, big A. And the sixth element after that is G. And the seventh element after A is H. And S plus 1, it is jump one element from S and write the rest, which is B, C. And here I have also copied that phrase in S, and I have put P is a pointer, and I have write P equal S plus 14, that it is the rest of the phrase after the 14th step, and it is shells by the seashore, which is shells by the seashore. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. While we are going to use pointer all the time in our another programs, and you are going to learn more.